Caring for cats has become a full-time occupation in this household. They arrive in droves. Injured, sick, ill-treated, or plain abandoned, it doesn't matter. They'll be given house room and all the nursing they could need. But now Dawn Travers needs nursing herself. She suffers from chronic internal abscesses. She's had one operation and is due for another this week. But she's refusing to go unless she can find temporary homes for her brood of 60-odd cats for the month she'd be in hospital.
I won't leave them. I do take the responsibility that I've taken on in life very serious. I can't go into hospital and just lay there knowing that there's all these cats here and all the vet bills to be paid, because they are extremely high.
But you have a responsibility to yourself, surely?
I do. But then when another big pair of brown eyes comes into you, you don't seem to care so much for yourself as for the animals.
And money is a problem. As well as the vet's bills, it costs a fortune to feed 60 cats. 9 crates of cat food, 12 tins of salmon, 12 of pilchards, 6 pounds of mincemeat and 6 chickens a week. And they get through 20 kilos of litter a day. Friends have tried to persuade Dawn that her health comes first, but she won't be persuaded.
They are more important than I am. They always will be. Because, you see, I can go out and fend for myself, but these poor little darlings can't. And they really don't ask to be born.
Some might say Dawn's dedication has become an obsession, but she's adamant. If she can't find homes for the cats, she won't go to hospital. Tricia Ingrams in Streatham, Thames News.